So today is the feast of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, or rather the solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Tomorrow we have the solemnity of John the Baptist, but we'll still celebrate the Immaculate Heart of Mary, since this is the Legion Mary retreat and we're at a marriage shrine, so we can do that. I think the Bishop of Auburn will let me do that. And so, to reflect upon today's Gospel, it's very beautiful. We know that this past Sunday we had the Feast of Corpus Christi, the Feast of the Body and Blood of Jesus. And knowing that the Sacred Heart is a beautiful time to reflect upon the mercy of God, of the fidelity of God, the great love that flows out of Jesus' Sacred Heart, pierced on the cross for love of us. And that the Eucharist is the Sacred Heart of Jesus. We can imagine, just put in your mind, but we'll have time for Holy Hour tomorrow, our Lord in the tabernacle, the host that's there. Imagine it pulsating for love of you, beating for love of you as if it were a heart. And in fact, it is. You may recall the miracle of Lanciano in Italy, when in the year 800, a priest who doubted his belief in the real presence of Jesus, that if the body and blood soul of Christ becomes present at the words of the priest on the altar, becomes human flesh in his hands, and the wine becomes actual blood. And in scientific tests in 1970 by the World Health Organization, from the United Nations no less, Professor Linoli examined what was still present there, this human flesh. And he realized, and the exam says this, it is myocardium, it is heart tissue. And it's fresh heart tissue, as if a doctor took a scalpel and went into someone's heart and kind of took a slither out and put it there on like a petri dish or something, or underneath some examination. And they just said, oh yeah, this is like just heart tissue that someone just cut out here. The Eucharist, of course, is the totality of Christ. We know that someone's heart represents the total person. And that he gives us of his own flesh to eat, his own heart to eat. So we become transformed in love, as he is love. Today is not, it's not one of those, I mean, we often think solemnities are times we can have celebration. It's not so much a celebratory feast. It is, because all feasts and solemnities celebrate things. It's a sad feast. It's the feast when Jesus appears to Margaret Mary Alacoque in the 1680s and bears his breast, shows her his heart beating, pierced, and crown of thorns. And he says, behold this heart which has so loved men, but has been little loved in return. That his heart is consumed with fire, consumed with love for us, and we do nothing. We much prefer rather to watch TV, or to go for a walk, or to not spend time in adoration, or sleeping on Sundays, not go to Mass. We don't love him back the way that he loves us. And this saddens Jesus. We know that God can't really be penetrated by what we do as human creatures. He's not feeling, he's not emotion per se, but Jesus is a human being. And he's hurt by things we do. And he's saddened by things we do. We don't honor and respect him or love each other as we should. And that is the sadness of today's feast. It is a feast of reparation, of making up for that which is lacking in ourselves, in our family, in our friends, in the world. I can't even read the paper anymore. It's so much nonsense everywhere. It used to be that, you know, I keep saying that every year, but it gets worse every year. You can't even figure it out now, it's so bad. Like, everyone's yelling at each other, and then our government and the world is just like, you don't know who the heck is right anymore. That person's lying, no, he's lying, no, she's lying, no, you're lying, no, the media's lying. It's just like, oh my goodness. You can't even begin to figure it out. It's terrible. We need reparation. We need that because we are all affected by original sin. We are all prideful, and we need to be humble. We got humility, we wouldn't be pointing fingers all the time all day. We'd be pointing at ourselves. This is where it starts. Because we're broken. Una perfect. When Jesus appeared to St. Margaret Mary, he told her, I want you to tell the King of France, Louis the 13th at the time or something, go tell King Louis to consecrate this country to my Sacred Heart, enthrone the Sacred Heart in this land, put it on a banner, and the royal banner, and it will protect this land. And so she wrote a letter. She wrote a letter to the King of France. It was like dated like July 14th, 1689. Dear King, Jesus Christ wants you to consecrate France to a Sacred Heart, signed Margaret Mary, and you know, whatever, and sent it out. Maybe she can send him an email or something, he never got in. But anyway, the King never consecrated France to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. You know what happened 100 years later? 100 years later, to the day, July 14th, 1789, was the beginning of the French Revolution. 100 years later, the French Revolution erupted in France, Bastille Day, which has to be my birthday, July 14th. That has to be a guess, it's just one of those things. And the king, and so they took over the country, hundreds, thousands of priests, religious sisters and brothers were killed and massacred, and bishops were thrown into jail, beheaded, between 1789 and 1793. Monasteries were closed. It wrecked the faith for decades. Then you had the Napoleonic Wars up. Europe was a mess. We today, in history books, you know, 1789, that's the beginning of modern history, that's the beginning of human freedom, that's, you know, the reign of the common man or something. That's so much baloney. That's just baloney. Put this on YouTube, it's baloney. That's the beginning of everything, of this false liberalism, false idealism, false of this rise of secularism, that we can create our universe, our world, our current without God. That's what secularism is. Secularism is that we think, as human creatures, we can be just as good and just as goody-two-shoes or as holy or perfect or whatever, and helping out our neighbor and helping out the poor without God. We can figure it all out by ourselves. But you know what that happens? Euthanasia, that's what happens. That's showing compassion to the elderly. That's not compassion, that's killing people. Oh, abortion. Oh, that's showing compassion to the unwed mother. That's baloney. That's what secularism does. It has false compassion because it's not anchored in the truth. It's not anchored in love. It's not anchored in true mercy. It's anchored in what people think is truth, or what they think is compassion or mercy. And our whole world, the whole modern world is writ large because of one failure to do reparation to the heart of Jesus. We're all paying the consequences now. But again, don't put fingers at everyone else. It's like, what have I done to offer up to Christ? What have I done to love Jesus the way that he deserves to be loved? I often have a tendency to talk too long in homilies or conferences, and I think the general people were angry at me for the past couple of years, so I'm going to try to stop and ask as well as I can. We need to look at today's feast and see, how is it that I can change the world? The only thing I can do is change myself. Ask the Lord forgiveness for my sins. We have an opportunity to go to confession this weekend. We could take an opportunity today, privately. Consecrate yourself to the Immaculate Heart of Mary tomorrow, to the Sacred Heart of Jesus today. Just make a little prayer of devotion. Say, Lord, I failed you so many times. I want to love you more. Help me to be holy. Help me to be a great saint. Help me to lead the world to love with you. Make me a victim of your mercy. Help me to spread devotion to you. We forgot about that. Think of the 1950s or something. The Sacred Heart of Jesus was enthroned in homes. We had Sacred Heart enthronements. We had special feast days. We had special devotions to the Sacred Heart of Jesus in our parishes and schools and things like that. That's all out the window now. Nobody does that anymore. We need to wrap ourselves in God's mercy. We need to say that Jesus is the King, not just the King of France. He's the King of America. He's the King of Massachusetts. He's the King of Boston. He's the King of my home. He's the King of my heart. And we need to put him back on the throne. Because we put people on the throne, people are false. People are fallible. People make mistakes. People are sinners. You have a leader who just makes mistakes. The whole country goes off. Put Christ back in the throne. and that things are better. We have to get rid of this false secularism that is so afflicting our society, and it's filled with moral relativism. The great danger of the world today is that no one knows the truth anymore. No one knows what